When dealing with conditional UI in FlutterFlow, you have two powerful tools, Conditional Builder and Conditional Visibility. But what exactly happens under the hood when these features are used and which one is more performant? Before we dive into the differences, it's important to understand widget trees in FlutterFlow. If you're not familiar with this concept, I recommend checking out the documentation. In simple terms, when you add widgets to your screen or component in FlutterFlow, they form a parent-child relationship arranged in a hierarchy we refer to as the widget tree. This tree represents how your UI is structured. When you trigger a state change such as updating state variables, FlutterFlow rebuilds this widget tree, ensuring the UI reflects the latest state values. When you use conditional visibility, in most cases, FlutterFlow generates code that wraps your widget with visibility, a widget from the Flutter framework. Your visibility condition is passed to this widget, which then decides whether to hide or show the child. This means that the target widget, such as the gallery section component here, is always part of the widget tree even when hidden. So remember that. Conditional Builder, on the other hand, works differently. When you use Conditional Builder, FlutterFlow generates an if-else block in the code. This means that only one of the components will be part of the widget tree at any given time, depending on whether the condition is met. For example, if this condition evaluates to true, component A is added to the tree. If false, component B is added instead. This approach allows for better performance when you only want to render certain widgets based on a condition. Now let's look at this further to see which method works best. In our previous example, comments view is shown when the replies count widget is clicked, which updates the state variable and triggers an API call. Now API calls are resource intensive and expensive. So in such social media feeds, you wouldn't want to load comments for every post by default, as it would unnecessarily increase the load time and performance cost. So Conditional Builder here is the right choice here, especially when you need to switch between multiple UI elements for different conditions, such as if, else if, and else. This way, only one component is part of the widget tree at any time, ensuring better performance and flexibility. So when to use Conditional Builder was straightforward. However, Conditional Visibility is a bit more smart under the hood. In most cases, it wraps your widget or component with a visibility widget, meaning your component is always part of the widget tree, whether shown or hidden. But remember, I said most cases. For example, when you apply visibility to a parent widget like the container from the gallery section component here, it manages the visibility based on the image list parameter value and if it is set and not empty. And that's a best practice. When you want to show or hide a component, delegate the responsibility of its visibility to the component itself rather than having the parent handle it. However, when the visibility target is inside a multi-child widget like the column or the row, list view, etc., FlutterFlow automatically switches to an if block in the generated code. For example, we have the likes card component in our row, which will be shown if the state variable likes count is greater than 0. This will ensure that the widget is only added to the tree when the condition is met. This improves the performance by reducing unnecessary rendering. So you can confidently use conditional visibility for simple if conditions where no UI switch is required. So what did we learn? When you need to simply show or hide a widget based on a single condition, simply use conditional visibility, and it's best to place the visibility logic inside the component itself so it can manage its own visibility. However, if the parent widget of the component is performing an expensive operation like an API call or onload animations, it's better to use Conditional Builder to prevent the widget from performing the expensive operation when it's supposed to be hidden. Or you can move that expensive operation into a child inside a multi-child widget and apply conditional visibility to the child. In these cases, FlutterFlow will smartly switch to an if block in the generated code to improve performance by excluding the widget from the tree when not needed. Additionally, use Conditional Builder when you need to switch between multiple UI elements based on different conditions. It ensures only one element is part of the widget tree at a time, improving performance. For more details, head over to docs.flutterflow.io.